Party, Sir John Ochala, and other members of the party. We will not go the litany of the protocol, but just to tell you that he's here with the deputy governor candidate in Tufam Eko Okon, who is also a traditional ruler by the title. And we have the senatorial candidate of our party here, Senator Pablo Inya, and other candidates of the party, Federal House and State House are here. Let me quickly introduce to you His Excellency, Distinguished Senator John Owaneno, the Senator representing the Central Senatorial District of Cross River State, and the gubernatorial candidate of APC Cross River State for the 2019 election, and with his dear wife. Let me also quickly, some of the leaders here have introduced the state chairman, other protocols, Julius, but I will not fail.
We are blocking the chiefs.
I will not fail to mention one of our own, a distinguished friend of Obaniku, Prince Ebuta Ojo Ayuk, and his wife. Their wife, they are here. It's a very dear friend of Obaniku. And let me quickly introduce Intufam Sidelis Ugbo, our host.
Right.
Call on the pastor that is here to lead us in the opening prayer. Very brief prayer.
Once again, I want to encourage you to support His Excellency. As the director of this protocol have just observed, waiting swearing in, come me, the chiefs, His Royal Highnesses and the Royal Majesty. I want to implore the heavens to bear us witness that it is not a child's play that our Saint John Owan will become the governor come the next tenor. Welcome to Obaniku here in this catchment of Obaniku. And we are blessed in prayers. So, gracious and everlasting Father, you ordain authority. And here is the Royal Majesties, Royal Highnesses, and other traditional rulers, bowing their head to tell you thank you for our brother, our son, who is vying for the next level of rulership. I ask that as a replica of divine heavens, I ask that you okay this meeting in his favor, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That the popularity he has made in the central senatorial district of our dear state, it shall also excel and expand to Obanliku and the Northern Crossbearer, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May heaven shake hand with you today.
Amen.
May Obanliku shake hand with you today.
Amen.
And may these Royal Highnesses that are here shake hand with you to your favor, and may heaven okay it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This prayer is made to your favor, and let heaven bear us witness that you shall be, and you shall be, and you shall be,
amen,
and you shall be,
amen,
and you shall be,
amen.
Humanly speaking, you shall be.
Amen.
I pray the Holy Spirit, amen, heal all your convoy, in the name of the Father,
amen,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God bless
you. Justin Oyona Apachon is the State House of Assembly candidate for Obanliku. Honorable candidate, Your Excellency, the floor is for you, sir.
The paramount ruler of Obanliku. Brand new, Abi?
Yes.
Brand new.
Terrible.
I congratulate you. The clanheads and the village heads. Before I continue, you know, our friend, our brother, and our great party man, in fact, two of them, Godwin Takus. You know him?
Yes.
Then Barrister Parabola. We know him as well, isn't he?
Yes.
Let us observe 1 minute silence for the repose of their souls. May the combined souls of Takus and Barrister Parabola and the souls of all the faithful departed, in the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Some of us, we're very committed party men, and we're very outstanding sons of Obanliku. Very committed, they loved this local government, and because of that love, and because the last 3.5 years, they didn't find anything going on in Obanliku in terms of development and attention, they preferred to join the APC. I'm going to be very brief, Paramahula. Even for their sake, the Paramahula, the clan heads and the chiefs of Obanliku should every day pray that the APC takes over the governorship of Cross Hill. Even for their sake. Obanliku is the first local government we are coming to. 18 local governments were starting with Obanliku. It's enough. Okay. I may come from a tomb, and I have Ikom, I have Ubra, I have Boki. But when I stretch outside of the central, it's Obanliku that I see. It's a very little child growing up with my dad in the family. We're surrounded by all Obanliku people. And harmony up to today. The people from Obanliku who are in my village at Bokun Waterfalls have declared a fast for me to become governor.
Amen.
They do so because they know me. And they know how much I love people when I've been elected by them. And I'm going to extend that love to Obanikun.
Amen.
You come from the north, I come from the central. But you know what? The 2019 election is not about north and central. It's not about that. I don't hate the people of the north. My problem is with Ben Ade, who hasn't governed properly. Somebody told me that a good friend is better than a bad brother. That's what it is. Chiefs, can you hear me?
Yes.
That's what it is.
Yes.
I hear you.
It is not brother in the mouth. It's what you can do because you have an opportunity. If the cattle ranch functions, if the baby estate functions, if the mountain race functions, it will change and control the economy.
Oh, yes.
All those three are no more. Are they?
Yes. Yes.
All those three
are no more.
So if you have somebody else who comes, it will be functional and more. Why would you support the person? And I'm not talking to you because I'm doing an election, I want you to elect me. In the central, what I say is what I do.
Yes.
Talk and do. That's why you can see from House of Assembly, I got elected 3 times to the House of Reps and got elected now to the Senate. It's not because they love my face, it's because they love my work.
Yes.
And that work, I want to do it for the whole of Cross River, starting from Obanikun. Many of you have civil servants, or brothers or friends of, go and ask them what has been their situation since 2015. Go and ask them. If Governor Eddie gets re-elected, God forbid, the state will just die forever. It will. I will not wait for 3.5 years to call for one of us and defeat them. I will not do so. Before the cards were given, find out what was the relationship between the governor and those paramount members. No relationship. It's because the election has come. Because the governor knows that he has a challenge and that he will lose. He's beginning to do things he never thought about doing. Some paramount members have called me to thank me. That is because of me that they got cast from governor. I said I'll be free, but I'm glad I came. I came directly to the home of the paramount member. I didn't invite him to come out. I mean?
Yes.
Yeah. I respect people. When people elect me, I respect them more. I don't think that I've become emperor or king. So I like the paramount flag, the clans and the chiefs to pray for me and to pray for all our candidates that are contesting the election. We have come with a message of hope. Where's Justin? Justin is our candidate for the House of Assembly. And you said you well. I cannot introduce somebody to you who will not do what I do. Did you hear me?
Yes.
As long as he's running this election, and I'm contesting it the same day with him, everything I did for it took me in the House of Assembly, he will do more for family.
Yes.
And I've seen him. And I need you to bless him and support him. If you want me as governor, and I think you want me as governor,
yes,
get elected as House of Assembly. Very important to me. Huh?
Yes.
And I've seen the work he's doing. You know, I've seen the work he's doing. Our candidate for the House of Reps, Ugo Obanikun Begbara, I hear he's still on his way. Not yet here. They call him Coco Dan. If he doesn't meet me here, I'm going to ask him, he's going to meet all of you again between today and tomorrow or next day. He'll come and meet me. Our candidate for the Senate, Rabbi Linyam from Ogoja. Fine gentleman. You know why? Fine gentleman. Very calm. Very peaceful, but also very committed and dedicated to his work. You need him. We need him. It will be important to support him and to vote for him. Very important, Paramount. So for me, is to pay you this respect and to tell you that we've started our campaign for the governorship, for the next election, the presidency. Nobody will defeat Buhari or anybody come and tell you that. Have you heard?
Yes.
Nobody. Nobody will defeat Buhari. People in PDP, big people, every day they are entering APC because of Buhari. Adamu Muazu, former national chairman of PDP. Don't you know that he has entered APC? Huh? Of course. When Ayade was campaigning for governorship, the person who was his campaign DG was Tufome Kpoku. You remember him?
Yes.
And he was state chairman of PDP, isn't he?
Yes.
So if me and Tufome Kpoku are running this election, can anybody defeat us?
No.
Eh?
No.
Finally, for 3.5 years, we produced next door to Obaliku, isn't it?
Yes.
Has the governor come here?
No.
Has he come to Obaliku?
No.
He has no need. He doesn't love the people he's governor over. If you don't love the people of Cross River State, then quit. You do well for your people because you love them. If you don't love them, you can't do well for them. And it's very important, don't be emotional or sentimental. If you are, then for the next 4 years, it will be worse than it is now. If you want something different, you want progress of this local government and of this state and of everyone, I have the magic to achieve that. Don't talk politics to you, I talk what it is, what is real. On election day, as we win in it, the next government I think we are going to win is Obaliku. Challenge me first by getting us to win. After challenging me, the first thing I will do, before anything else, is to come here and to come and thank you. That's what I do, and that's what I do. What I will do, that's what I did in the central. Very important to us. This election is very important. I didn't want to speak for too long, but the more I speak, the more the importance of this election gets to my head, the more I keep speaking. All our people, our campaign coordinators in the villages, the communities, in the wards, in the local government, I'm going to keep talking to you. If I can, I'll come back. If I don't, I'll come back after I become governor.
Maybe you should have a vote of thanks.
The campaign DG is just going to present something now. Is that how the key? We don't want to make mistakes of
it. That's okay.
My uncle visitor in July, sorry, in January.
Yeah.
Distinguished Senator John Wanino, and in a very near future, is swearing in a. General of the campaign team, please permit me to stand on the existing process. Everybody is respected in his own particular position. I once more say welcome to Jesus' name. It's like our visitor who have just spoken knows every nook and crannies of Obaliku, and it's like he knows the problems of Obaliku. I think by the time our address will break to the senator, the town hall meeting, we'll be able to see the numerous problems that we want you immediately you become. You need to help us to catch it. There are things about roads, water, electricity, what have you. But one thing I want to remark here is the issue of security. Like in Obaliku, 3 years ago, something happened. And my youth got up and burned down the police station. It's like after that, all our efforts in Obaliku to see how the government will still recognize the police headquarters in San Kome in Obaliku have defaulted. So right now, as we are talking, If there is a crime, I got to do. The policeman have no vehicle to come in. Not even a single vehicle. So as you are doing your campaign, I'm not saying when you become. As you are doing your campaign, please, if you have what it takes, provide a functionable vehicle. So that so many other things that are happening within Obani. Like the incident that happened that when the SS Bozia was killed. Maybe it would have been the DPU, not the SS. But he has to be there because the DPU have no death. He has to be situated and carry the DPU to the police. And he has to die for a thing that has not been done. But if you help us, in the right of so many other things. Then another one is if you look at the traditional way, maybe one or two only have well dressed. It's not because that we, it's not because we don't want, I mean we don't want to be well dressed. The stipend that I give it to this chief is too minimal. What time most of us are not even respected within our community. But what makes one to be respected nowadays is when the pocket is talking. It's when your pocket is talking. When you are able to put up a fine building for yourself. At least you have a car to drive on the road. In our close by neighbor local government, Okwande local government. Let me say Benue State. All 3 years are attacked in the cars. But the cost of escape, not even the price of that has been our time. In fact, what will you use? That is why a young man will get up and say, come and go and sit down. You will have to keep quiet because what have you to challenge you? Nothing. Then another one is you, the politician. The politicians are undermining this winter. Do you know that these people see good day and night? And that they are sitting in the council. They are paid. So please, as you go, tell your people to respect this. For most of your supporters are from us. Within our community, all of them are. So please tell them when they come back, they should yes. Chiefs are not politicians. We are not politicians. But we are political animals, we do. We are not partisan politicians. And you will not expect that after here, you will drive in your convoy to escort you to escort. No. I will go out to public place and begin to talk to people. Vote this party, vote this party. No. All the parties belong to the chiefs. We are fathers of all the parties. We are not brothers. We every party is taking shape. So as you leave now tomorrow, you see another candidate coming. You begin to look at me twice to listen to what I'm going to say. I will not say anything more than what I'm saying here. And now that you have come to Manuku, we are going to pray for you. That as you go, the God we are serving will pave the way for you.
Amen. Amen.
It shouldn't be a do or die affair. Yes. Have it in mind that if it is me, God give it to me. Just like I used to pray when I was campaigning for my own seat. To interest you that I'm not up to 2 months old as a paramount of this election. Yes. My prayer was, God, if it is my own, give it to me. But if it is my brother's own, give it to that my brother. And the thing worked out that I became a paramount of this. It's a mystery that God alone can explain. Just, and I'm giving you that spirit. That have that spirit. Even if it is not me, I am going to work with my brother, who has been, like my predecessor,
who left for me. To say, come, I contested with him. And some of my guys contested with him. But at the end of the day, he said, let's give it to him. One day he called us and said, Emma, you, Akosa, that thing you had at the back of your mind to develop this traditional religion, bring it so that I can add it to my own. So if you become, tell your brother to bring the idea he has to add to your own. He said, two good heads are better than one. If that is done. What we are shooting for is that everything should be carried out in such a way that there should be peace in process. My children, do we want war?
No!
Do we want to make a fight?
No!
Do we want north, center, south? Because you have already seen it and you know what is happening. You have driven to me. And you have even come to my palace and you see what is going. So I'm expecting as you are going. You say maybe the deputy governor will come and check, take inventory of what is to be done there so that you can assist me. Give me a break. It's like after a year, you are looking for another president. The client from there called me to find out whether you would have any place. On behalf of my traditional rulers and the entire people of Mabango, I say welcome to Mabango. And God, by God's grace, you will become the governor of the state tomorrow. Like I said, today will be your number one. It don't should be your number one to me. No, Banuko, you are number one to me. Banuko cannot be second. Yeah? And so, as you go, we'll keep praying for you.
Thank you.
Every of your person that is supposed to come and work with you, including my friend,
Thank you. Thank you so much.
We'll not spend time on getting to the place.
Please, because they want to leave the place.
Avaluko, Pianique, Pianique, the Fresha, the Genisha, Uganda, we are the Moa, Ujukatela, Nous avons bien pu faire la.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you very much.
Paul has come to come and collect.
That's it.
Oh, my God.
local government area on the occasion of the campaign visit to town hall meeting by distinguished Senator John Owalenon, the governorship candidate of APC Cross River State, and the campaign organization to the local government area Monday, 14th January 2019. His Excellency, all other protocols to the
summarize it.
I want to welcome you formally to Balibu and to inform you that the Paramount has invited you. And just go straight to the points which he has mentioned so that you know why we are here. We want to welcome you and assure you of the support of the people of Obaliku. Like you rightly know, over 50% of the people of Obaliku live in the Dom and Liban local government areas. And you have played host to them. And because of that, the Obaliku people are happy. The economy of Obaliku is driven by rich and offensive that are in Liban. So we want to assure you of our total support from to make you and inform you that the challenges we have had here and the unfeeling that official visit by any government official by night as a senator representing the federal Republic of Nigeria, you are the first senator and the governor as candidate of APC to visit the area. We want to inform you that the legacy of Your Excellency Donald Duke and Senator Lady Boke have been battered and eroded in Obaliku. The last resort is a shadow of this glorious year. The safari suit of Totanga looted and part of two burnt down by state fire because of the great and abandonment. The usual glamour and international events and the completion of the mountain range is gone. The tourism potentials of the land and other Islamic elements to bring to the economy of Obaliku local government area and the state international has been those air. We, the people of Obaliku, because we have found a friend in you and a son, and people say that the world is going to worry. The meaning is that another person's child is also their child.
Very happy with all of you, right? Thank you for coming out. We wanted this to be a town hall meeting, but the Obaliku people have turned this to a campaign rally, and I thank everyone for doing so. Obaliku, thank you. Obaliku is a goal. Obaliku is a goal. Obaliku is a goal. Now I'm going to be very sharp. I've seen the address. That has been read by the deputy campaign DG. There are so many things here from item 1 to item 15. As I leave Obaliku, I leave with this address. I can assure you that before, on the day I presented my master plan for the development of Cross River, your candidate for the House of Assembly, Justin, he gave me a list, and everything in this address is in the list that he gave to me. Now, when you elect me as governor on the 2nd of March, this address and this item from number 1 to number 15 are the things that I'm going to do for the Obaliku people. As the governor of a state, you are elected to develop those that have voted you, isn't it?
Yes.
Now, I want to pay courtesy call on the paramount ruler, the clan heads, and the village heads. And I ask them, since 2015, when you elected Governor Ben Ayade, has he visited Obaliku?
No.
He has not come here one day. One day he has not come here. right? I have not even been elected yet. Today's visit to Obanlikun is the number 4 visit that I've come to Obanlikun. And I thank all the Obanlikun sons and daughters that have found it fit and have embraced the APC and our agenda for the development of Obanlikun and the entire Cross River State. I thank in particular Ntufam. No, I want people to complete it. Ntufam.
Fidelis Ubo.
Fidelis
Ubo.
I wanted him to complete it.
No, sir.
Because he is the one and only Ntufam.
Yes, sir.
Huh? He has worked for you. He loves you and you also love him.
Thank you, sir.
He cannot take you to a direction that is not the correct direction.
Yes.
I thank Ukangi Chief Inekafe. I thank him for being part of this movement. I thank the former Speaker of the House of Assembly of Cross River State, Maurice Ebe. And I thank everyone else for coming out. I told the chief that, you know what, if the Budukato Ranch, if it functions, if the BBS Street, if it functions, right?
Right.
If the International Mountain Race, if it functions, it works for the people of Obanlikun.
Yes.
The community of Obanlikun will change, isn't it?
Yes.
For 3.5 years going to 4 years, all these three things, are they function?
No.
Are they working?
No.
Is there any reason? Is there any reason why on March 2nd, anybody from Obanlikun, man or woman, old or young, is there any reason why any of you will cast his vote for Governor Ben Ayade? Is there any reason?
No!
Now let me say this. I'm not the only one that is contesting this election.
Yes.
President Muhammadu Buhari is running.
Yes, sir.
Let me tell you why you have to vote for President Muhammadu Buhari. His election is on the 16th, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
After 2 weeks is my election, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
If you want me as your governor, and I know you want me as a governor, isn't it?
Yes.
Also give me President Muhammadu Buhari. After you have given me the president, the next 2 weeks election is finished.
Yes, sir.
Have you heard me?
Yes.
After you have voted for him and he has won. After you have voted for Wabili Inya. Where is Wabili? Where is Sokodan? Where is Justin?
Come,
please come. Yes. Justin, do you know him?
Yes.
You know?
That's our son.
You know when I went to the House of Assembly in 1999? The people of Etum sent me to the House of Reps together with the people of Obubra, and they sent me three times. Three times. And now they send me to the Senate in the Central.
Yes.
You know why they keep electing me? Because I do the work that they want.
Yes.
When my people elect me, I don't forget them.
Yes.
I don't wait for election before I go back to them. I told the Paraman ruler that if I'm governor, I'm not going to wait after 4 years before I give Paramount rulers their cars. I will not do so. All that one is election gimmick. Now, you know this fine man? Wabili Inyam is your candidate for the Senate. Don't you want a change? Don't you want a change? Now, where is Kokodan? Go support him.
Yes,
when I go vote for him,
yes,
if we support him, when I vote for him, he go do better for him more than anybody else. I'm sure you know, so isn't he? Now, you people have heard of Ntufam Ekpoko, have you?
Uh-huh.
You know Ntufam Ekpoko, isn't he? He was, somebody said King of Boys.
Yes, sir.
He was state chairman of PDP, isn't he?
Yes, sir.
In 2015, he was the campaign DC for PDP, isn't he?
Yes.
In 2019, he's the deputy governorship candidate. Huh? In the South, they'll say, oh, maybe so. Maybe so. Now, we're going to live here and we're going to go to Obudu. When we live here, we're not leaving the work. We're leaving Obanlikun in the hands of our various campaign coordinators.
Yes.
In the wards, in the local government, in the communities, and in the villages. I can assure you one thing, that where I come from is a Tumuku government. As a little child growing up, I grew up with a Banliku people, and they still live in Agbokun Waterfalls. I told the chief that since I became candidate to run for governorship, every Banliku mother and father, child, man or woman, daughter or son, they declare a fast because they know that I'm a good man. And they want the Banliku people here at home to support the person that they think is a good man. Therefore, I need all of you to join me in working to change Cross River State. I bring the message of hope. President will be better for all of us. So today is the first time we have started our campaign for the governorship and for the 2019 election. Obanliku is the first local government that we have come to. On election day, let Obanliku be the first local government to deliver the APC. In the hands of Tupam Fidelis Ugo, your own son, right?
Yes, sir.
APC! Yay! APC!
Yay!
I want to tell you one thing. You know me that I have always been a planner.
Yes.
And if I see a good thing, I follow it.
Yes.
When my brother from another mother came to me and said he wanted to run for governorship, and I asked him, what plan do you have for Cross River State? He brought a document and showed me, this is my plan for Cross River State. And do you know what he told me? He said, the government of PDP in those days, they had a 24-year plan for Cross River State. That plan was followed for 16 years, and after that, the plan has been destroyed. And we cannot sit back and see our state being destroyed. If you follow a man that has no direction, he takes you to where you don't want to be. Today he has come with a direction. He has come with a plan that will take Cross River State to the next level. I want to appeal to all of you, my brothers and sisters, this is the time. You know me, I cannot follow anything that I do not believe in. Today, we are moving to the next level. The person that is taking us to the next level is His Excellency Senator Owan Eno, the next progressive governor of
I want to inform.
Inform.
I want to inform.
Inform.
Inform.